service tonight at 7. And there'll be no choir or handbells this week. And the items for the New Hope Ministry will be due next Sunday. Okay, now if you'll join me in the call to worship. Let us go with the shepherds, the wise ones, the poor and humble.
Let us go to find the Savior, to find God's promise, born for us, to find our King, born in a lowly manger. Come, let us worship. Come, let us adore Him, Christ the Lord.
You may be seated. Now, if you will turn to the fourth week of Advent, the insert in your bulletin. I will sing of your steadfast love. O Lord, forever with my mouth I will proclaim your faithfulness to all generations. I declare that your steadfast love is established forever. Your faithfulness is as firm as the heavens. You said, I have made a covenant with my chosen one. I have sworn to my servant David. I will establish your descendants forever and build your throne for all generations. New life is coming.
We have in the days now.
God is breaking through.
God's word will change the world.
We will all be changed by the language of love.
The covenant has come down.
The love of God is never ending.
We give thanks for God's faithfulness.
Today we light the candle of love.
We give thanks for God's steadfast love.
To be consecrated to the glory of Almighty God and for the service of this church and the Redbank Valley Church Association Food Pantry. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, we consecrate these food items to the glory of God. Let us pray. Most loving God, without you, no words or works of ours have meaning. Accept the gifts of our hands as symbols of our devotion. Grant us your blessing as we have consecrated these items to your glory, that it may be an enduring witness before all your people, and that our lives may be consecrated in your service through Christ, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And now, pray with me as we pray about this emergency. Heavenly Father, we don't know why the fire whistle is blowing, but we know you know. And Father, we just pray for your hand to be upon this emergency. Whatever it may your protection preside over the whole incident. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. And now as our ushers come forward, let us prepare our hearts and our minds for the giving of our tithe. on the eve of your son's birth, we gather here in joy and thanking you and praising you for all your blessings and how you provide for us and take care of us. And we lift up these gifts to you, such a small return, but we pray that you can multiply them for the betterment and the growth, and may they always glorify your kingdom. In Jesus Christ's precious name, amen.
Amen.
And now it is my joy and honor and privilege to turn this service over to Bill and our wonderful choir.
The time when eternity would be altered forever. This was the moment when condemnation would meet redemption, when the free reign of darkness would meet the light of the world. The time was now. And as the curtains rolled back from a divinely set stage, all of creation rose and stood in silence.
From the mount of Bethlehem.
The silence of Christmas began long before the birth of Christ. For 400 years, God was silent. From the final words of the prophet Malachi until the proclamation of John the Baptist, from the time between the Old Testament and the New Testament, there were no prophecies, no revelations, no direct communications with his children. What kind of God would leave his people in silence for 400 years? A God who keeps his promises. A God whose attention to detail would not allow the plan of redemption to unfold prematurely. You see, God is often silent while he is working. During those 400 silent years, God was resetting the world stage. Key prophecies were being fulfilled. The nations of the world were repositioning themselves to be in direct alignment with the scripture. For the first time in history, the Hebrew prophecies were being translated into another language, the universal Greek language, allowing for all nations to recognize the Messiah at just the right time. There was a plan. Galatians 4:4 says, "In the fullness of time, God sent forth his Son to be born of a woman." But while the curtain was closed, and while God was silent, his oppressed children were crying to him for deliverance. just as he hears our cries today. And he sent a deliverer, his only son, a savior who is Christ the Lord. And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And all went to be taxed, everyone into his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you: ye shall find the baby wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill